John Cheever was born in 1912 and he died in 1982. In between, he was a high school dropout, an alcoholic, a depressive, one of Raymond Carver's drinking buddies, an active bisexual, a short story writer, and a novelist. It might seem odd to describe him that way, putting the private before the public. The point I'm trying to make is that he was unconventional, because a casual reading of his short stories alone could suggest he was the flat opposite. His background was New England upper middle class, and his writing looks to be entirely the product of that, eloquent and precise, urbane and intellectual. His characters tend to be middle class white people with little interest in the world beyond their social circle. In most of his photos, he looks like a senior executive from Mad Men, clean cut, wealthy, and probably dull. There's a true story about Cheever which sums up his contradictions. In 1966, he went to see a psychiatrist to whom he divulged that his wife was hostile and prone to dark moods. The psychiatrist asked to see the couple together. Afterwards, his report described Cheever as, quote, a neurotic man, narcissistic, egocentric, friendless, before going on to accuse him of being delusional enough to invent a manic depressive wife. In 1966, when men tended to band together even more than they do now, that must have been fairly unique. And of course, it's very funny. Cheever may have been a bit of a mess at this point in his life, but his writing never was. He's one of the great short story writers of the 20th century. The Stories of John Cheever was published in October 1978, and it sold in shovelfuls. Plus, it won the 1979 Pulitzer Prize for Fiction, the American Book Critics Circle Award, and the US Book Award. Cheever's most famous story is probably The Swimmer, about a man who traverses a suburban landscape by breaking into his neighbour's gardens and swimming across the various pools attached to their houses. But my favourite is the much more atmospheric Goodbye, My Brother, which begins the collection in most English versions. It's about a widowed mother, her three sons and one daughter, and their separate families on an annual family get-together stroke vacation. Lawrence is the youngest of the three sons. He's different from his mother and siblings, and he dislikes them. He comes across as contemptuous and embittered. The narrator, Lawrence's brother, is never named, and we only ever see things through his eyes. It's a story about conformity, the ravages of time, light and dark, and moral integrity. But that's true of most of Cheever's stories. They broach issues which concern us all.